Welcome to the UU Treehouse in Santa Fe. I'm Stephen Mead and friends to tell another story this morning that we can have fun with and learn something from. Today's story comes from Ancient Stories for Modern Times, written by Faye Morganson. This story is called Grandfather and Grandson. He was old. His wife had died, and his son and daughter-in-law invited him to move in with them. And in a few years that he had lived there, he'd grown more and more frail, and more forgetful, and more clumsy. And it was hard for the daughter-in-law. She had so much to see to already, with the children, the garden, and the household chores. One day, it was suddenly too much. He knocked over the bowl again. Not only had the soup spilled all over the table and soiled the beautiful embroidered cloth, but the old man had broken yet another one of her fine bowls. That night, when the grandfather sat outside, the daughter-in-law said to her husband, "You must carve or buy a wooden bowl for the old man." "A wooden bowl? I'm tired of him breaking my good dishes. Better he eat from something that won't be ruined if he drops it." And having broached the subject of her father-in-law, it was as though a dam had burst. Well, all the grievances poured forth. "I'm tired of the way he complains. He'll say the tea is cold, but that's because he forgets to drink it. I'm tired of the way he changes his mind. He doesn't even seem to know what to do. I'm tired of his endless chatter. He says the same things over and over again," and she went on and on. "It's embarrassing when the neighbors come by. Perhaps we can set a table for him in the nook around the corner." Well, the man understood his wife's complaints. He too found it challenging to live with his father. But he may have been about to suggest a solution even more drastic. We'll never know. A sudden movement caught his eye, and his wife's. It was their son. He was rummaging about, he was looking for something. "Ah, what is it, sweetie? What are you looking for?" asked the mother. "Well, I'm just looking for some wood." "What for? Do you know?" "Yeah. I'm going to start carving wooden bowls for you and Dad. I want to be all ready when you are going to get old." The boy's parents stared at the boy and then at one another. And at that moment, they understood how wrong they had been. The father went outside to invite the grandfather to join them for tea. And the daughter-in-law set the grandfather's favorite cup and saucer before him. And they were made of porcelain. There was no more talk of a wooden bowl nor of a nook around the corner.